Whoa! I'm so excited, guys. This Intel GPU, it just keeps looking better. No, it's not going to beat the RTX 3090 in terms of outright total performance, but it is going to beat Nvidia and AMD in these key metrics. Let's talk about it. But before that, this video is brought to you by me. That's right, I finally got the merch store up and running. So if you want to go ahead and support the channel, go ahead and go into the description. There will be a link as well as in a pinned comment to the new merch store. And right now we do have like a limited edition shirt up on there right now. As soon as it's gone, it's going to be gone for good. This design is never coming back. So if you want it, this is your only chance. It's very limited run. There's not a whole lot of these available, and it is 10% off right now. So if you want a sports show, go ahead and click that link. But in any case, let's get right into the video. Woo! These Intel GPUs are starting to look mighty impressive, guys. I recently just got a hold of these specs that were posted over on 3dcenter.org for the upcoming Intel GPU that's the biggest boy that they're going to be releasing. And yeah, it's starting to look really good. In fact, the performance might even be a little bit higher than you were expecting. It is actually going to be a little bit higher than I was originally expecting, which is definitely good news. So don't worry, we will be talking about performance, we'll be talking about specs, and we'll even be talking about the release date for Intel's upcoming GPU, and we'll be comparing it to the RTX 3070, 3070 Ti, and 6700 XT. So if you're someone who's in the market for one of those GPUs and you want to wait a little bit longer until GPU prices come down, this Intel GPU might be something that's going to be a good option for you. But first of all, you're probably wondering, well, how is Intel beating AMD and Nvidia? And like I mentioned in the intro, no, it's not going to be like outperforming the RTX 3090 like I just talked about. We're more talking about like RTX 3070 levels of performance, but the way it's going to be beating AMD and Nvidia is in terms of the technology available in this GPU. So the first thing I want to talk about when it comes to Intel's GPUs, and it's going to be an area where I do believe Intel is going to actually be beating AMD as well as Nvidia, is going to be their answer to DLSS, which they're calling XESS or Z super sampling. And this is so impressive because it seems to actually combine the best of both worlds between these two different options coming from AMD as well as Nvidia. Because on AMD's side, they have FSR, which works on every single GPU, but it's not quite as high quality as DLSS, although it is very good. But on Nvidia's side, you have DLSS, which works really great basically at every single resolution. Of course, as the resolution goes down, it doesn't work quite as well, but it does seem to work better than FSR at those lower resolutions. But if you take a look at the XESS coming out from Intel, at least from what they showed, it looks, you know, really, really impressive. The demo they showed looks impressive. But on top of that, the technology that they talked about looks like it's going to be a leg up both over AMD as well as Nvidia, like I just mentioned, because it looks like it's going to be taking the same type of way that Nvidia does their DLSS by, you know, using a whole lot more frame data to make these new frames and to try and interpolate using AI what the frame should be looking like. But at the same time, they're going to allow it to be used on all GPUs. Now, it is going to work best when you use Intel's GPUs because they are going to have those essentially like AI tensor cores, much like Nvidia has. However, it is going to work on every single GPU. So here, right away, I think Intel's going to have a major advantage in this area. And depending on how easy it is to implement this technology, it could end up actually being the technology that wins out over AMD and Nvidia. I definitely don't think that Nvidia is going to be the one that wins here. I think, you know, having it be a proprietary solution is not going to be the way forward. So I think it's going to be really a big fight between AMD and Intel, because Intel's should look a little bit better. It should work a little bit better, but AMD's might end up being just that little bit easier to implement. So whichever wins, I'm not entirely sure right now, but I do believe that Intel is going to have the best technology when it comes to these three different ones that are available. So that's going to be, first of all, a huge win for Intel. The next area where I do believe Intel is going to have a leg up and is going to beat AMD and Nvidia as well, they're actually beating them to TSMC 6 nanometer, because right now Nvidia is on the Samsung 8 nanometer node, which is basically a retrofitted 10 nanometer node from Samsung, and then AMD has actually had a node advantage over Nvidia using TSMC's 7 nanometer node. But it looks like Intel's actually beating AMD to the punch, and they're going right for that TSMC 6 nanometer node, and this could potentially give them a leg up over both of these companies when it comes to their power consumption or their clock speeds. You know, it's all going to come down to how good their architecture is at the end of the day. But this is going to allow Intel to get the best performance per watt out of their GPUs as they can possibly get right now. So that's yet again another area where Intel is going to have a leg up over these two companies, which is surprising considering that they're a new entry into the GPU market. But hey, I'm just glad that we have three different competitors. I'm so glad for this. I've been waiting so long to have three competitors rather than these two companies that, let's be honest, they basically don't really compete with each other anymore. They kind of just slot in their video cards at prices where they don't have to worry about competing, and the prices just continue to go up and up and up and up. So hopefully, if Intel sets their prices at a reasonable level, we'll get prices that actually start to come back down, which is something that I think we all desperately need to see. But in any case, now let's go ahead and get right into the specs and why I'm so excited about this Intel GPU. You know, beyond just the different advantages that I just talked about, why this GPU I think is going to be so good, especially for high resolution gaming. And now this information I'm going to be talking about was posted on Twitter by 3dcenter.org, but we actually can see here there's a chart comparing the RTX 3070 die to the 6700 XT die to Intel's newest biggest GPU to see, you know, what GPU is actually going to be claiming the performance crown when it comes to this segment of the market. And so first of all, the thing I want to actually highlight here is the FP32 units, because right here we can see that the Intel DG2-512, or the biggest Intel Arc GPU that's coming out, is going to have 4,096 shaders compared to NVIDIA's 6,144 and AMD's 2,560 shaders. Now, these are all different architectures, so we can't for sure say which one is going to be the most powerful just based off of this data. However, if I was to guess, I'm guessing that this Intel GPU is going to slot somewhere between these two GPUs when it comes to its IPC. So I think this is a good look here for Intel right away with its FP32 units. I think that's enough to get them into that performance range that will do them very well. But now moving on to the TM user texture mapping units, we can see that Intel has 256, NVIDIA has 192 on its 3070, and then AMD Navi 22 has 160. So here actually Intel has an advantage. Then moving on to ray tracing units, they have 32, NVIDIA has 48, and Navi has 40, although I do believe that Intel is going to be a little bit closer in ray tracing performance to NVIDIA rather than where AMD's kind of lagging behind a little bit. And then if we move on to its Tensor cores, it actually has 512 XMX cores, which are kind of like the AI core Tensor cores that NVIDIA has, and NVIDIA has 192 Tensor cores, and actually 3D Center is kind of estimating that it's going to have about 131 TFLOPs of FP16 performance, whereas NVIDIA has 87 TFLOPs of FP16 performance, and AMD has only 25. So it looks like at least 3dcenter.org believes that Intel's going to have the best AI performance out of these three GPUs, and honestly, I kind of believe that too. I wouldn't be too surprised. And then finally, if we move on to the ROPs, we can see here Intel has 128, NVIDIA has 96, and then AMD has 64. So once again, Intel actually does have an advantage here, and I think this is going to help them at those higher resolutions and help them get that little extra boost that they need to compete with GPUs like the 3070 and 3070 Ti at 4K. And then actually, finally, if we move on to the memory interface, we can see Intel has 256-bit G6, NVIDIA on the 3070 Ti is using 256-bit G6X, and then of course Navi is using 192-bit G6. So it looks like Intel, I believe, especially with that 16 megabytes of smart cache that's listed here, you're going to be looking at a GPU with memory bandwidth similar to the performance you're seeing out of the 3070 Ti. So if you take that and you also consider the fact that this GPU could have up to 16 gigabytes of VRAM, it's also going to have the most TMUs and the most ROPs, I believe this GPU is going to be very good at doing 4K gaming, and it's probably going to be closer to that 3070 Ti levels of performance when it comes to that 4K gaming, especially when you consider if you're using a technology like DLSS or their XMX cores to use their XeSS type of technology. I think it's going to be really great for that high resolution gaming, and when it comes to 1080p gaming, I think it's going to be at least as fast as about the 6700 XT. So somewhere between 6700 XT and 3070 Ti, I think it's going to depend on the resolution as well as if you're using AI super sampling. But this GPU is looking a lot more powerful than I originally thought, and again, I think it's going to do very well at those high resolutions. But finally, let's go ahead and touch on, you know, the actual release date of this GPU, and it looks like, at least according directly to Intel, it is going to be coming out in the first quarter of 2022. So if you're someone who's waiting for GPU prices to drop, like I mentioned earlier, I would definitely wait and see what Intel has to offer here. And to be honest with you guys, they might actually be able to even outproduce AMD and get more GPUs into the market than even AMD is able to do, because right now AMD is only producing like, you know, 10% or less of the GPUs that are making their way into the hands of gamers. So I wouldn't be too surprised if Intel is going to actually be able to make more than that, but only time will tell. Either way, this is very, very exciting stuff. I think Intel's got a real winner on their hands here. All they got to do is, price it appropriately and get enough of them out the door to actually satisfy gamers. But hey, that's just what I think. What do you think about Intel's GPU? Do you think it's actually going to be as fast as a 3070 Ti, or do you think it's going to be closer to like a 3060 Ti? Let me know your guys' thoughts in the comments below, and of course, I'll see you in the next video. If you made it to the end of the video, be sure to drop a like. Every time you do so, AMD and Nvidia get more stock. Also, if you want to see more, click here. You won't be disappointed.